Use time tracking to track the hours that your employees and vendors work for you. Open the Create menu, and underneath Employees are two time tracking options, Single Time Activity and Weekly Timesheet. Single time activities are normally used by professional services companies, and with this sort of time tracking option, you can enter the name of the employee or vendor who performed the work, what day the work was performed on, the customer, if they worked for a particular customer, as well as the service that they performed, and if the time is marked as billable, you can also enter a billable rate. Finally, you enter the amount of time that they worked for that particular activity. Most of the time, however, people enter time for a weekly timesheet. Weekly timesheets are also accessible through the Create menu underneath the Employees section. Weekly timesheets are more common because it allows you to enter all of the time that an employee or vendor has worked over the course of an entire week all at once. Up at the top left, you choose the employee or vendor's name from the list. And then right here, you also choose when the work was performed. We're going to enter time for last week. The customer field allows you to track who the work was performed for. This is optional, but if you want to bill the customer for the work, you do have to include a customer's name here. Next, you can also include a service item. This comes from your products and services list. Again, this isn't required, but if you want to track specifically what the employee or vendor did during this time and then also bill the customer for that, you can choose it from this list. Here you can mark the time as being billable to the customer and then also fill in the rate per hour. Then over here on the right, we'll enter the number of hours per day that this employee or vendor worked. They worked for 8 hours every day of the week. Notice that the timesheet also has Sunday and Saturday labeled right here. You can turn those off by clicking on the gear icon and then unselecting any days that your employees or vendors don't work. Finally, there's also a copy last timesheet. So if your employees or vendors perform the same work every week, you can just click on this link to bring over the information from the previous week. Now let's save and close. It's important to note that time is a non-posting transaction, which means that the time we just entered will not impact any of our account balances at all. But you can track the time through special time reports available in the Report Center. Up here at the top right, just type in time, and you can see all of the time report options. Recent edited time activities by customer detail, time activities by employee detail, and then unbilled time for a listing of all the time you've entered that was marked as billable, but you haven't included on an invoice to a customer yet.